FreeSchool 101.
Although most famously associated with ancient Egypt, mummies have actually been made in many places around the world throughout history, both intentionally and accidentally. The Egyptians, however, refined the mummification process into a highly effective method of drying and preserving the body after death. Some mummies were so well preserved that even thousands of years later we can get a good idea of how the person looked in life. The earliest Egyptian mummies were likely produced by accident, as bodies were buried in pits of desert sand and dehydrated naturally in the arid climate. Evidence for intentional mummification has been found as far back as 5,600 years ago, although it appears that the Egyptians did not achieve true mummification until about 2600 BC. The practice of mummification continued for over 2,000 years, extending into the period following Rome's conquest of Egypt. Although lower quality mummification would have been available for poorer Egyptians, pharaohs would have received the very best preparation for the afterlife. This process of mummification took about 70 days and served two major functions: dehydrating the body and protecting against pests. First, the internal organs would be removed, beginning with the brain. A rod, or hooked tool, was used to break up and remove the gray matter, although sources disagree whether the tool was inserted through the nostrils or the cranium. This procedure was delicate, and the embalmers had to take care not to damage the face. Once complete, the inside of the skull would be rinsed, and sometimes filled with linen or tree resin and fragrances to protect against odor and decay. Next, the abdomen would be sliced open and the internal organs removed. Unlike the brain, which was discarded, the heart would be left in place, because the ancient Egyptians believed that the heart was the center of a person's being and the source of human wisdom. The stomach, liver, lungs, and intestines would be treated and either placed in canopic jars to be buried with the body or wrapped and replaced inside the abdomen. Then it was time to dry things out. The body was packed and covered with natron, a naturally occurring chemical salt, where it was left until completely dried out, up to 70 days. When dehydration was finished, the body was removed from the natron and washed, oiled, and covered with resin. This resin acted as an adhesive, securing the linen wrappings to the body. Hundreds of yards of linen were required to wrap a single mummy, sometimes beautifully decorated or painted with prayers and spells. Within the wrappings, there might be placed protective amulets. At several points, more resin would be added, followed by still more layers of wrapping. It was common for a mask of the person's face to be added, and particularly fine mummies might have extra jewelry or treasures tucked in with them. The extended time required for mummification allowed for preparation of the deceased's tomb to be completed. Tombs of the wealthy would often include elaborate paintings, furniture, statuettes, and treasures, which were intended to travel with them to the afterlife. Once the completed mummy was placed in its tomb, an important ritual called the opening of the mouth was performed. This ritual was intended to awaken the mummy and allow the person who had died to see, hear, eat, and speak again. Following the ritual, the dead person would be able to use and enjoy the offerings in their tomb. The funerary rites were complete, and the dead were left to enjoy their afterlife.